Yes guys, welcome back to Petrolhead TV and welcome back to a brand new video. So today Michael's brought down this lovely Nissan 350Z. So as always, let's go into some cinematics of the car, then we're going to go out for a quick drive. So I'll see you in a sec.
Waiting for very close to messes. So if I go and pick him up like the same weekend, then he'll let me have a discounted rate. So naturally, just jumped in the van, straight up to Bradford, picked him up, came straight back home. And the following weekend, I dropped him off to have him rebuilt to the desired offsets.
Yeah.
And that's probably, like, out of everything I've done, was the most terrifying thing, because it wasn't, but it wasn't cheap. Yeah. To rebuild them. And like,
so what kind of money was we talking to do that?
The rims were set me back 800.
Yeah.
I think the labour was about 700 quid, and then I think it was another £700 for the new dishes.
Yeah.
And I think paint was about, I can't remember what I paid it for paint, about 300 or something like that.
Yeah.
But it was just a lot of money, just because this is the thing, like the lips were 700 quid, so if I got the measurements wrong for the offsets, it would have meant new lips or barrels.
Yeah.
And when I test fitted them for the first time, and I was dropping it, you're literally talking like you have millimetres on plate, and I must have broke the numbers down about 50 times before I actually came into a final offset.
Yeah.
Just to make sure they were right. And obviously, like, when I dropped it onto the tyres, it was like, you can't go back from that.
Yeah.
Because once the tyres were on, you'd fitted them, you know. But luckily it all went fine. I had the rear arches rolled to accommodate for the, because they're 11J at the rear now.
Yeah.
No, sorry, tell a lie, 11.5.
Okay.
And I took them to Carson Performance and they rolled the rear arches for me.
Okay.
So it's all done in prep for the new wheels, but it just sort of sets it off much like. I've always wanted like three-piece splits on this. I wanted something a bit different from like the Meisters or SSR, because you see them all the time at shows.
Yeah.
And these are quite uncommon, so I was sort of determined to
be a little bit different with them, really.
What about like engine wise, is there any sides on there?
No, the engine's pretty standard at the minute. So the engine variant in this is VQ35DE, which is the single intake model. I think from factory it came with 280-ish, 289 horsepower. You know, don't get me wrong, it's a natural gas operated V6 lump, does all right. I don't see a massive difference between them. I think if you're going to track it, I would probably go with coilovers. Yeah. But I think for street and daily usage, it's airbags, because if I don't catch on nothing. Road humps aren't a problem. If there's a road surface that's slightly more aggressive than normal, I can just press a button and I'm up.
Yeah.
What I did really notice as well was when I had the air suspension fitted, it was a V2.
Yeah.
Which is, it was a few years old by Airlift now. But when I changed over to the 3P management, the difference in performance is just unbelievable. Like, it handles so much better. It holds the road a lot nicer. And it monitors the amount of pressure in the bags a lot easier.
Okay.
But for me, I think I would never go back to coilovers now, unless it was a dedicated track car.
Yeah. Interesting.
It's just a lot easier. Obviously with the 3P as well, it's all like Bluetooth control.
So obviously you can use it on your phone?
Yes.
Oh, wicked.
So with the 3P, it was like this really old-fashioned looking wired unit.
Just yeah.
Like, and it was sort of like sitting dangling, at least like this, it looks a lot better.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm pleased with it. You know, I wouldn't change it. I think, you know, when you compare it to the factory suspension, I didn't notice a huge amount of difference. It handled just the same to me. I think the only way I would knock it is that if you're running with like slightly higher PSI in the bags, it does get a little bit bouncy.
Right, okay.
But you'd have no reason to be that high and be going that fast. It's only to sort of clear an obstacle.
Yeah. For anyone interested in like a system like this, how much roughly would this cost to do? Roughly, like.
I think you're looking
at it's different on various cars.
It's obviously different. I think the standard package sort of starts from around about £3,000 for airlift.
Right.
And that's for your airbags, your compressors, your tanks. There's a new brand that's just come out, Max Load. So they're like the Chinese copy of Airlift. They normally retail at about £1,000 less.
Okay.
Now I've never driven with a Max Load system, but I have seen the kit last time I popped down to have it. And all intents and purposes, it's exactly the same as Airlift. It's just that it's made by a Chinese company, so they don't pay for the branding of Airlift.
Yeah.
But I've known someone with a 350Z exactly the same as this, and he's had it all fitted and it's been absolutely no problem. It handles the same as this, as far as I'm told.
Yeah.
So yeah, I would say about £2,000 or £3,000 odds. I think when I had this done, I paid about £5,000 in total, but that was funny. The install, the boot build, they did some arch work on it and everything else, so
yeah.
It was a bespoke job. It wasn't just like off the shelf and whack it in. But that said, I think for anybody that's looking at doing it, you can do it yourself. I would definitely, if I bought another project and put it on air, 100% I would do it myself next time. Having now like a bit of familiarity with it, 100% I would just buy the kit off the shelf. You can literally do it over a weekend. I mean, if you can fit coilovers and you can wire up a sub, then you can